Hello, I am Krishna Raghavendran, and in this tutorial of MIT App Inventor, we are going to see how to create a voice calculator using MIT App Inventor. So let me show you how this works. First, I need to click on Ask Question, and I need to tell a math question. 7 plus 5.
The answer is 12.
Now you can see that it shows 7 plus 5, the answer is 12, and you can also see that it told. So this can perform addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. Now if you are new to my channel, I create tutorials on MIT App Inventor so that you can create fantastic mobile apps like we are going to do in this tutorial. So start now by clicking the red subscribe button so that you can create fantastic Android mobile app. So first we are going to bring in a label and we are going to put this to be at the center of screen 1. So click on screen 1. And change align horizontal and align vertical, both should be center. Now you can see that the label 1 came to the center of the screen. Next, let's change the text of label 1 to be question. Now let's make the font of this to be bold and we are going to increase the font size to be 25. Now you can see that the font size is increased. And then next we are going to bring in another label and in this label we are going to put the text to be, we will just put a hyphen like this, and then the font size should be 14. I think 18 would be okay. Now you can see that the font size is 18. Next we are going to bring in another label and this label is for spacing. So we are going to put answer, so we need a space for this. That's why we are using this label. Now let's erase all the text and we are going to put the height to be 2%. Click on okay. Now you can see that there's a gap. Let's duplicate this label and we are going to put this here under the label 3. And let's change the text of this label to be answer. Next we are going to duplicate this label to Ctrl C and Ctrl V and we are going to bring this here below answer. So here the question will be visible, whatever we have asked, and then here the answer will be visible. Next we are going to bring in a button. And let's change the text of this button to be ask question. Now we are going to make the font of this to be bold and let's increase the font size to be 18. So the user should click on this ask question button and then they will ask the question. And then after we ask the question will be visible in label 2. And then this mobile will find the answer and it will show it in label 5, this label. So now we are going to use speech recognition to find whatever the user is speaking. So let's go to media and from here we are going to bring in speech recognizer. Next we also need text to speech because the mobile will speak back the answer. So if the answer is 5, then the mobile will tell 5. So that's why we need text to speech. So let's bring it in. Now let's go to the block section. So we are going to create 4 variables. So let's bring in this and we are going to put the name of the first variable to be number 1 and here we are going to put 0. Now you need to duplicate this and change, we need in the other variable we are going to put number 2 and then let's duplicate this and in this variable we are going to put operation and in the next variable let's duplicate this again, we are going to put it to be answer. Now let me explain you why we are going to use 4 variables. So I'll give you an example. So let's say the question for this is 7 plus 5. So here you can see the question. So in 7 plus 5, the number 1, this is the number 1. So 7 is the first number. And then number 2, 5 is the second number, which is number 2. And then the middle one, which is plus, is the operation. So we are going to save it in this variable and then at last this mobile will find the answer and then we will save it in this variable. So let me just change the text to be hyphen and now let's go to the block section. Now next when button 1 is clicked, so button 1 is this button ask question. So when the button is clicked we need to enable the speech recognizer. So let's go here and here you can see call speech recognizer dot get text. You need to bring in this block. Next, after the voice recognition or the speech recognizer gets the text, So let's bring in this after getting text. We need to show the question which they have asked in this label, so which is label 2. So let's go here and we are going to bring in this block, set label 2.text2, and then we will get the result. So the result is whatever the user has spoken. Now before we continue further, let me first explain you with a simple example how we are going to do the blocks. So let's state a simple example like 7 plus 5. So first what we are going to do is wherever there is a space, for example between 7 and plus there is a space. So we are going to split wherever there is a space. After we split it, we will get 3 items. So 7 is item 1, plus which is the operation is item 2, and 5 is item 3. So this is how we are going to get the numbers and we are going to find the answer in the block section. So let's bring in this block, set global number 1, 2, and then I told you that we are going to split it as I told you before. So let's bring in, we are going to go to text and we are going to bring in split at spaces. So wherever there is a space, we are going to split it. And then after we split it, I told you that there'll be 3 items. One is number 1, the second one is number 2, the second one is the operation or the plus sign, and the third one is number 3. So we are going to use a list for this. Select list item. Let's bring in this block. The list is going to be, we are going to split the result, which means whatever they speak, at the spaces, and then we will get 3 items. In that, number 1 is the first item, so the index is going to be 1. Now let's duplicate this, and here let's change set number 2. The same way, we will split at the spaces, and number 2 is the third index, so because it's the third item. Let's duplicate this again, and we are going to get the operation sign. And the operation sign is the second index because it is the second item. Now we have all of these ready. Now we can start doing the calculation. So first let's bring in the if condition. If we are going to bring in the equal to operator from here, math blocks. And here we are going to check whatever the operation is. I told you that this app can support addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. So we will get the global operation. And if it is equal to plus, so let's bring in this and let's put plus here. So if the global operation is equal to plus, then it needs to add number 1 and number 2. So we are, after it adds, we are going to set it in this variable. So set global answer 2. We are going to add it using the math blocks. So let's bring in this. And here we are going to add number 1 and number 2. So we will get the value from number 1. Let's put it here and let's duplicate this, and here we are going to put number 2. Next we are going to duplicate this if condition, and if the global operation is minus, then we need to subtract number 1 and number 2. So what we are going to do is we are going to bring in the subtraction from here. So let's put number 1 here and number 2 is going to be here. I'm going to delete this. Now you can see that we have finished subtraction. Let's do the same for multiplication and division. Now you can see that I have done for all these 4 operations. So I have done for multiplication and I put the multiplication operator, and I have done for division too. Next, we are, after it gets the answer, which means we have saved it in this variable, we need to show it in label. So we are going to show it in this label, which is label 5. And after we show it, we are also going to use text to speech so that the mobile will speak out the answer. So let's go here and we are going to set label 5.text2. We will get the answer. So let's duplicate this and let's change this to be answer. Next, after we do that, we need to use text to speech so that the mobile can speak. So let's bring in this block, and the message is going to be, we are going to use the join block because we are going to add something with the answer. So let's bring in this, and here we are going to put the answer is, and then you need remember to put a space, and then here we are going to put the global answer. Now here you can see the app. I'm going to ask few questions. So let me ask a question on addition first. 7 plus 10
The answer is 17.
You can see that it shows 17. Now let me ask a subtraction question. 5 minus 5.
The answer is 0.
Now you can see that it using text-to-speech, it tells 0 and it also shows 0. Now I'm going to ask a multiplication question. 5 multiplied by 5.
The answer is 25.
You can see that it shows 25. Now let me ask a division question. 50 divided by 10.
The answer is 5.
You can see that it answers all the questions correctly. Next, do you want to create a translator app which can translate to any language you want using MIT App Inventor? Watch this video and also watch the full course of MIT App Inventor here.